Hey everyone, so welcome to this video. So in this video today we can compare that two powerful processors. So one is Intel i9 and that another one is Apple M2 Pro actually. So we have both powerful chips actually, that processors. So we have compared the two processors. One is that 14 crores and against with the 12 crores actually. So in that video, you will be find out that benchmarks and games and a single core performance and a multi-core performance and a nano review and a power efficiency final scores. So end-to-end thing you will be get actually, which one is better other than that actually, right? So don't skip that video and let's deep dive into that. I'm very much curious to compare that both processors. So let's start with the general overview with a single core and a multi-core and a power efficiency, nano review, final scores like that actually. Let's start. So in the single core performance level, both processor have the same score actually. So Intel Core 9 out of 100, it's taking as a 85, and Intel M2 Pro out of 100, it will be taking the same as 85 actually. So it's expected, right? Let's see about the multi-core and the power efficiency and a nano review. Yeah, in the multi-core performance level, same as, so Intel i9, it takes 61 out of 100 actually, but it's a big surface. M2 Pro, it will be taking 59 out of 100 actually. So in that multi-core performance level, Intel i9, it's own actually. So let's dive into that power efficiency. So in that part, power efficiency level, to score of electricity consumption, right? So in that Core i9, it will be taking just 72, and M2 Pro takes surprisingly 98 out of 100 actually. So in that part, M2 won, right? So yeah, next let's we start. Generic CPU rating. So in that generic CPU rating level, based on that overall performance actually, so in that part i9 will take 73 and M2 Pro will take 79 actually. So but these all the reviews are just number wise only, right? So based on that your requirements, maybe it will be slightly will do some changes actually. Generic CPU rating. So in that generic CPU rating level, based on that overall performance actually, so in that part i9 will take 73 and M2 Pro will take 79 actually. So but these all the reviews are just number wise only, right? So based on that your requirements, maybe it will be slightly will do some changes actually. Let's start with the Cinebench R23 benchmarks. So I just recorded the two kinds of benchmarks. One is single core, another one is multi-core. So in that single core level, Core i9 will it take 1955 scores out of 2000, and M2 Pro will it take 1667 actually. So in the single core level, Cinebench R23 level, Core i9 have a better performance actually. And if I take that multi-core, so in that multi-core level also the same, Core i9 will it take 18,230, and M2 Pro will it take 15,170 actually. So Cinebench level R23, single core and a multi-core, Core i9 processor have the better performance compared with that M2. Then passmark CPU. So in that passmark CPU level, single core level, i9 will it take 3800, and M2 Pro will it take 4152. It's around 9% of better performance compared with the i9 for the M2 Pro, right? Along with that, same as passmark CPU, in that multi-core level, so Core i9 will it take 29,162, and M2 Pro will it take 26,633. It's around 9% of better performance compared with that M2 Pro, right? The next part I can show with that Geekbench 5. So in that Geekbench 5 single core level, So in core i9 will it take 1807 actually. So M2 Pro will it take 2019. So it's around 12% of improvements actually, better performance compared with that i9. And if you see that multi-core, so in that same as i9 will it take 13,552 and M2 Pro will it take 14,982. It's around 11% of performance improvement compared with that i9 actually. So just now we saw about the performance and benchmarks related things, right? But a few of the things we need to know, like performance cores, efficient cores, and GPU and memory supports like that actually. So in that, if you see that Intel Core i9 have that 14 cores, 20 threads with a bus frequency of 100 MHz actually. But M2 have a 12 cores, 12 threads, and it doesn't have any bus frequency and a multiplexer like that actually. But Intel Core i9, so that is support L1, L2, L3 cache with 8K, 1MB and 24MB shared thing actually, it will be support. But in that M2 have that 192K along with the 32MB with the shared, L3 doesn't have actually. We hope you found this video informative and helpful. If you did, please hit the like button and consider to subscribe our channel for more videos like this in the future. Also, don't forget to share this video with your friends and colleagues who might find it useful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below and we'll be happy to respond. Thank you for watching. We'll see you on the next video.